Hi friends, myself Subrata Mukherjee, and I will today discuss about cost of capital. Cost of capital deals with different components of capital structure. A firm raises its capital through equity and debt. Cost of debt and cost of equity is computed from two different point of view. Cost of debt is computed from firm's viewpoint, and cost of equity is computed from investor's point of view or owner's viewpoint. In this video, we will try to learn what are the different ways of computing cost of debt and cost of equity. How the different formulas that are used in computing cost of debt and cost of equity will be analyzed in detail. All of you know how to compute simple interest. SI is equal to PRT by 100. Here we are having four parameters. One is the interest. Second is the principal or the face value. Third is the rate of interest. And fourth is the time. Interest is computed on the face value. In order to calculate the component R, which is calculated by cross multiplication of SI and 100 and by dividing it by P and T. This is the concept which is used when we compute cost of debt or cost of equity. Coming to cost of debt, debt is of two types. One is irredeemable debt and the other is redeemable debt. In case of irredeemable debt, the amount taken by the firm from its lender are not paid back and annuity is paid on the amount borrowed. Cost of debt of irredeemable debt is computed by KI is equal to I by SV into 100 and KD is equal to KI into 1 minus T. KI is the cost of debt before tax. I is the interest paid. SV is the sale proceeds of debt or the market value of debt raised by the firm from the lenders. And KD is the cost of debt after tax. The formula which is used for calculating cost of debt is the same when we compute R in case of simple rate of interest. The parameter T is removed because T is taken as 1 because interest is computed annually. In simple rate of interest, I is calculated on face value, and in cost of debt before tax, I is also computed on the face value. While computing cost of debt before tax, we are calculating what is the effective rate of interest on the market value of debt raised. Here, the relation between P, the face value, and SV, the market value of debt, will be analyzed. When debt is issued at par, market value of debt is equal to face value of debt minus the flotation cost, which is denoted by F. Flotation cost is the administrative cost incurred to raise the debt. When debt is raised, then there is a cost incurred for the service of the intermediaries, which varies from 4 to 6%. When debt is issued at a premium, market value of debt is equal to face value plus premium minus flotation cost. When debt is issued at a discount, the market value of debt is equal to face value minus discount minus flotation cost. So we can easily remember the formula of cost of irredeemable debt if we apply the concept of computing R of simple rate of interest. R is the absolute rate and KI is the relative rate. Now coming to cost of redeemable debt. KI is equal to I plus RV minus SV by N divided by RV plus SV by 2, where RV is the redemption value and N is the tenure of debt.
if there is a difference of redemption value and the proceeds of debt, then the difference per year will be adjusted with the annual interest, and the sum total of the numerator is the annual interest payment and the denominator is the average debt involved in the business. So we can easily remember the formula of cost of redeemable debt if we apply the concept of computing R of simple rate of interest. Now coming to cost of equity. All of you are familiar with the different ways of computation of cost of equity. These are dividend model, dividend growth model, earning model, and earning growth model. Which model is used depend on the nature of the investor, that is whether the investor is a long-term investor or a short-term investor. If the investor is a long-term investor, then earning model is used. And if the investor is a short-term investor, then dividend model is used. But while solving the problem, cost of equity is computed depending upon the information given in the question. KE is equal to D1 by P0 into 100, where D1 is the dividend per share or the expected dividend per share at the end of the year. And P0 is the market price per share at the beginning of the year. Here also the same concept is used. In the numerator, we have the dividend, which is the return of the equity holder, which is the same as interest. As interest is the return of the debt holders, dividend is the return of the equity holder. In the denominator, we have market price of the share, that is the amount invested by the investor or the owner. In the beginning, I have mentioned that cost of equity is computed from the investor's point of view. Why? Because this market value of share is the amount invested by the investor, and it has no impact in the profit and loss account of the firm. The earnings is the total annual income of the firm. A part of the earnings is retained by the firm and the part is distributed, which is the dividend. So a long-term investor considers the earnings model, whereas a short-term investor is more concerned with the amount of dividend distributed. The parameter G or the growth rate is applied where there is a constant growth rate of earnings or dividend distributed by the firm.
So in this video, we learn how to compute the cost of debt and cost of equity. Thank you.